Hi folks, my name is Snigdh. I'm a creative producer and I work in the creative digital spectrum using 2D, 3D, motion graphics and visual effects. Since the last 9 years, I've also been teaching these forms of art. Today, we're going to learn how to model, rig and animate a bicycle chain and see how effectively you can use this technique to create some wonderful animation of a pedal, crank, chain wheel or a sprocket, all connected in a realistic way. If you like what I teach, please consider subscribing and also press the bell icon for instant updates whenever I release a new video. So let's get in right away. Continuing from the previous video where I had explained you the basic procedure to create a single chain link, now is when we begin creating the instances of the chain link and connect them all together. Okay, to begin with, I'll go to Edit, Duplicate Special, reset the dialog box and put it on Instance. Since we don't really know the math here, I'll just start off by creating a duplicate by pressing Ctrl D and simply move the group to the place where it wants to be. That way I would exactly know the translation values and the associated axis. Number of copies? I don't really know that either. So I'll call in Google to help me with this. Let's ask it. Something like chain links in a cycle chain. Let's see what it comes up with. Nothing useful here. Let's try number of chain links in a cycle chain. It's given me something. Okay, here. It's telling me there are 56 links. That's helpful. Thanks, Google. So let's input 56 here. And what was that number in translation again? I think it was 3 point something. So it was 3.43 in the x-axis. Everything looks good. Let's hit it. Zoom out quite a bit. And we see a long chain right there. Select it and hit the combine button to combine the entire mesh. Freeze transformations, delete by type, history, and center pivot. Now it's bending time. Head to the deformer menu, nonlinear, bend. At its default, the bend controller will not give us the desired curvature. Hold down the E key to activate the rotate gizmo and press J to activate rotation snap and rotate it to 90 degrees on the z-axis. Let's scale it in the x-axis, modify the curvature settings to 180 degrees, scale the controller down till the time the chain links meet up on their ends. Okay, so we are getting close now. Now we need to rotate the controller on y-axis to 90 degrees. Again, scale it till the time the ends meet. Okay, great. Freeze transformations, delete by type history and center pivot. Scale down the entire setup to proportion. Now here is where I think we need to bring it in a circular shape. We are going a little off here. Scale it a bit in the x-axis. And that's our final shape. So this is where I end the part 2 of this video. In this video, we saw how to take a previously modeled chain link and put it on a curve using a NURBS circle. In the next video, I'll be showing you how to put it all together. So see you in part 3. Till then, take care and never stop creating.